Good morning, I'm Eric Scott. This is New Jersey's First News for Wednesday, January 12th. We are waking up to very cold temperatures this morning, below freezing, but our chief meteorologist Dan Zarrow says we are going to see a little bit of relief today. The bad news is another Arctic blast is coming towards the end of the week. We have full forecast details available on air, online, and on our free mobile app. After failing to get a 90-day extension of his pandemic powers, Governor Murphy, as predicted, has taken matters into his own hands. He has declared another public health emergency. It allows his existing executive orders to be extended. That includes the controversial school mask mandate. It also gives him unilateral powers to impose new restrictions. Though Murphy says he doesn't expect any new mandates, any new restrictions, any new closures, but he is certainly free to do so. The legislature had the opportunity earlier this week to be able to cap the governor's power. Any executive order would be limited to 15 days and then have to be extended by the legislature. But Democrats, in a party-line vote, tabled the bill that had been sponsored by Republican Brian Bergen. We have more on that at nj1015.com this morning. The renewed health emergency comes as the state's COVID metrics continue to trend in the wrong direction. New Jersey reporting another 142 deaths related to COVID. More than 20,000 New Jersey residents are testing positive daily. Hospitalizations remain above 6,000, with more than 800 needing life-supporting care. The state's metrics, however, have come into question of late, with health officials admitting around half of those admitted to the hospital were for underlying conditions and just happened to test positive for COVID. Still, Governor Murphy claims of those being admitted with the virus, 92% are unvaccinated. Governor Murphy gave his State of the State speech. It was basically a rehash of old news. It wasn't live. It was pre-recorded at the Trenton War Memorial. There was no live audience in place. We have highlights of it at nj1015.com. He recapped the last 4 years and the current state of the pandemic. A new item he said will be on his agenda is the cost of prescription drugs. Murphy says he'll send the legislature a plan to address prescription drug affordability, centered on making pricing across the entire supply chain more transparent in an effort to address what drives drug prices higher. If you have been trying to find a home COVID test, you know that they've been sold out at most pharmacies. Supply chain issues partly to blame, although some pharmacies, particularly independent chains, are getting regular supplies. They are, however, selling out in about a day. Even shipments of testing kits from places like Amazon are taking weeks to arrive. The Biden administration claims the supply chain issues will be addressed in the weeks ahead. More than 580,000 test kits being made available by New Jersey for free to residents of the state have been requested so far, but Vault Health is struggling to keep up with demand. They do say most of those kits are shipping out on time. Whether you buy a home kit from a pharmacy or online, the Biden administration now says your insurance company has to cover the cost of up to 8 tests per person per month. For a family of 4, that's 32 test kits per month, if you can find them. Again, the Biden administration says they're working on supply chain issues. Meanwhile, Walgreens in New Jersey is now stocking 2 antiviral pills designed to treat COVID at home and hopefully keep people out of the hospital. One is made by Pfizer, the other is made by Merck, but who will get priority on the prescription pill is still unknown. A Hillsborough committeeman remains silent this morning after his whispered profanity landed him in some hot water. During a recent committee meeting, a local resident was pleading with members to enact a town mask mandate. Committeeman Frank Delcor could be heard on mic saying, "Oh, Jesus, same thing, bleeping masks." So far, Delcor and the mayor have refused our requests for comment. One of the attorneys for one of the students charged with a Wall Township High School hazing incident says this matter is getting blown way out of proportion. Attorney Chris Adams says he has seen video of the incident. On Monday, the Monmouth County acting prosecutor announced juvenile complaints against an unspecified number of juveniles, charging the students with hazing, attempted criminal sexual contact, false imprisonment, and harassment. But the attorney, Chris Adams, says this was not an incident that was sexual in nature. It was essentially just boys being boys. Coaches and other adults, he claims, were present at the time of the incident. We have full coverage of this at NJ1015.com. New Jersey lawmakers have sent Governor Murphy a proposed law that would expand New Jersey's plastics ban to include packing peanuts. It would also require common products like plastic bottles include a certain amount of recycled content. New Jersey has already banned plastic bags and plastic straws in the Garden State. Who doesn't like a good "it's so cold" joke? Our Jeff Dominski has put together a new list, "It's So Cold," but with a Jersey twist. You can check it out and add your own at NJ1015.com this morning. Have something to say about our top stories? Leave your comments right here. Please like and share this video. And remember, we're always taking your calls, talking Jersey on air on New Jersey 101.5. I'm Eric Scott. That's New Jersey's first news for this Wednesday, January 12th. Have a great day.